Today I will be using basic household equipment to make a sundial. This experiment will demonstrate how shadows cast by the sun can indicate solar time. Aim. The aim of the experiment is to create a sundial using common household materials. I hypothesize that the shadow cast from the stick will slowly move clockwise around the plate at regular intervals. Method. In terms of materials, you will need a plastic plate, a knitting needle or skewer, markers, 4 fishing sinkers or small weights, a compass, and the optional extra of glue. In terms of method, you will need to first, mark the center of the plastic plate so that you know where to make your hole. Next, using the mark, poke the knitting needle or skewer through the center, ensuring that the stick is at a slight slant. If needed, use glue to secure the skewer in place. Third, find a spot outside that will get full sun exposure all day. Fourth, using the compass, find north if you are in the southern hemisphere or south if you are in the northern hemisphere, and place the sundial so that the slant of the stick is facing that direction. Next, you will need to secure the sundial by placing the weights around the edge. At the next hour on the dot, mark where the shadow is being cast and the time onto the plate using the markers. Your dial should look like this. Repeat step 6 until the sun goes down or for as many hours as possible for the best results. Experiment.
Tune down to the ocean side, the sky's blue and hope is high. You went left and I went right.
Results. The lines marked at each hour on the dial created even sectors, clearly indicating that the sun moves at a constant rate, rising in the east and setting in the west. Overall, the experiment effectively demonstrated how a sundial can be used to tell solar time. Discussion. The findings challenged my hypothesis due to the shadows moving counterclockwise rather than clockwise. Upon further research, I discovered that this was due to being in the southern hemisphere, and if I were to repeat the same experiment in the northern hemisphere, the shadow would move clockwise. I was, however, correct in stating that the rate at which the shadow moved all day would stay constant and therefore create even sectors round the plate. The experiment was limited in the fact that it had to be performed on a sunny day in a location that was able to receive direct sunlight for the full duration. The only risk associated with the experiment is the pointed end of the knitting needle or skewer, specifically when it is being used to pierce a hole in the plate, as it could result in an accidental stabbing. To avoid the occurrence of this, teacher assistant / observation is highly important, or alternatively, the hole could be made using a different method, and then the skewer could be replaced by a soft object such as a straw to eliminate the risk. Credits.
I'm coming home. I'm on the road, I'm on the road.